Just kidding. Chocolate chip. Yeah. Yummy.
Oh, Ron. Well, Inspector Clueless has really given the guys some cases to work on. And you've done really good.
I tell you. Now, this is a song that I think we should sing tonight. Because, you know, if you have Jesus in your heart, and we're talking about the case of the complaints, does anybody like to be around anybody that complains? How? I don't like being around anybody that complains, too. But I like to be around somebody who has happiness and is joyful and has Jesus in their heart. And so we need to make sure that that's what kind of a light we are for Jesus. So let's stand up, get your lights ready, and let's sing This Will Light Your Mind.
He fills us with love, joy, peace, kindness, gentleness, faith, all kinds of good stuff. Jesus fills us up in the promises of God. Man, that is so pretty, isn't it? That's just a pretty blue. But, I have some stuff right here. Does anybody know what this stuff is? Who knows what it is? Yeast. Yeast. Does any of you bakers know what yeast does? What does yeast do? Right, it makes bread to rise. Does it take a whole lot of yeast to make bread rise? No, it just takes a little bit for it to rise. How many sins does it take to miss heaven? 50? 200? I heard? One? Only one?
So what does yeast stand for, Joe?
Yeast in the Bible stands for sin in our life because it only takes one little lie. Then you got to cover it up with a bigger lie and a bigger lie and a bigger lie and a bigger lie. And then you get a bad attitude and then one. And then you start fighting and one thing leads to another. We're just going to pour in a little sin.
Do we have to?
We don't have to, but she sinned today.
Aww.
So
she can't go to heaven. Joe, that's enough sin.
Oh no.
What?
We just poured a little bit of sin in there and all of a sudden it's spewing out.
So I want you to pray with me tonight. Dear Heavenly Father,
Dear Heavenly Father,
I thank you.
I thank you.
That I don't have to sin.
That I don't have to sin.
That your grace is greater.
That your grace is greater.
Than any sin.
Than any sin.
And your power can help me.
And your power can help me.
To live above sin.
To live above sin.
And to help me stop sinning.
And to help me stop sinning.
And so Jesus.
And so Jesus.
I'm sorry.
For every sin I've committed.
For every sin I've committed. And everything I've done wrong.
And everything I've done wrong.
Please forgive me tonight.
Please forgive me tonight.
Take away all of my sins.
Take away all of my sins.
Give me a clean heart.
Give me a clean heart.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
Save me.
Save me.
Live inside of my heart.
Live inside of my heart, Jesus.
Amen. Every head bowed, every eye still closed. We're getting ready to turn around. But here's what I want to do is tonight. I don't want us to ask God for anything when you kneel down and pray. But I wonder if you can think of five things. We have the case of complaints. You know what the cure for complaints is? It's thankfulness. And so I want you to think of five things you are thankful for. Can everybody do that tonight? And I want you to tell Jesus, Lord, I am thankful that I have a pastor who cares about us young people. I thank you, Lord, that we've got Sunday school teachers that care about us, children's church workers that care about us. I thank you, Lord, for a mom or a dad or grandparents. I thank you for toys and food and clothes. Lord, I want to get rid of the complaints tonight. I want to learn to worship you.